Hello, Dr. Croker here, and this is a guide to Castrum Meridianum. With patch 6.1, this dungeon was essentially rewritten from beginning to end. This guide is updated to the new version. Please like and subscribe. I'm releasing guides for every story dungeon and trial in the game, so you always know what's coming. Let's get started. There are no special objectives here, just trash and bosses. The first boss is the Black Eft. From the beginning of this fight until the end, there will be plenty of adds. The tank should be able to grab all of them without any issues. The boss will often cast high-powered Magitek Ray. This does heavy damage in a line pattern in front of the boss with no marker. Just watch out when his face starts glowing. He will also cast Request Assistance, but this is just him calling in more adds. There are a variety of Imperial Soldiers and Colossus adds, but again, the tank should just grab everything. Incendiary Support deals unavoidable damage to everyone in 3 small bursts. Magitek Cannon is a circular AoE hit with a marker, just step out of it. After the first boss, the next several trash pulls have constant AoE markers, just keep moving. The second boss is Magitek Vanguard F1. He'll cast Thermobaric Strike, which puts a pulsing proximity marker near one corner. Just move to the opposite corner to reduce the damage. Hypercharge is an ability that covers the floor in AoE damage, aside from one thin, safe circle you should stand in. Surmit Drill is a heavy hit on the tank. Just use mitigation and healing as needed. Overcharge sometimes follows Thermobaric Strike, and it's a frontal conal attack that can be avoided by stepping under the marker. Lastly, there is Targeted Support, which marks every player with an AoE circle. Simply step aside to avoid getting hit. After the second boss is some trash, then an unskippable cutscene. The final boss is Livia Sastunius. She'll often cast Artificial Plasma, which deals unavoidable moderate damage to everyone. Roundhouse is an ability where you'll see a circular marker at the center, followed by mini circles around the edge. Just stand in one of the edge markers at first, then after the center one goes off, move to the center while the edge ones go off. Aglaia Climb is a heavy hit on the tank. Infinite Reach is a fun one. You will see many AoE patterns covering the entire floor many times over. Order matters here. Just watch the order that the markers appear and know that they will explode in the same order. Always be standing in a new marker or a blank space when there is one, and you'll be fine. She also has an ability called Thermobaric Strike, but in her case, as soon as the cast goes off, she will cast a second spell. You will see AoE patterns on the floor, followed by proximity markers. There's enough time to avoid everything. Just note that when there are 2 proximity markers, you should stand here to minimize the damage. And later, when there are 4, you want to stand in the center. Near the end of the fight, she will cast Artificial Boost. This gives her a buff so that when she casts Artificial Plasma, it will deal slightly more damage. Instead of one moderate blast, it will be 3 to 4 small ones, but overall it's slightly more damage. And that's it for Castrum Meridianum. Have fun and see you next time.